children, in the previous video we have discussed about rational numbers which are having terminating decimal expansion. But in this video, let us see rational numbers which are having non-terminating and recurring means repeating decimal expansion. Okay, let us go through the examples first. Here 1 by 3 is, let us divide 1 by 3. 1 divided by 3. Okay, we have to start with the decimal point. Okay, what do you observe here? The digit 3 is repeating as many number of times, right? So only this particular digit 3 is repeating. So we can write 1 by 3 as 0.333, etc. Means how many number of 3's will come, we don't know. So since this 3 is repeating, we can show in this way also. 0.3 bar means that digit is repeating. So the part which is repeating is called the period. Okay, or the block, we can call it as the block. So here the period is 3, means the digit 3 is repeating. And how many number of digit is repeating? Only one number of digit is repeating. So that number of digit, how many number of digit it will be repeating, that we call as periodicity. So what is the periodicity here? 1 is the periodicity. What is the period or the block? Is 3. Okay, let us see this example. 5 by 11. This also we have to go on with the decimal first. 0 point. How many number of times? 4 times. 44. 6. How many times? 5 times. 55. Again, the same one, that means 5 reached. Okay, first what is the dividend? Again, we got the same dividend. That means same number of digit will be repeating hereafter. So here, the number of digit repeating is 2. And which are the digits repeating? 4, 5. So, you will be getting 5 by 11 as 0.4545, etc. That means we can write in this way. 0.45 bar, that means this block is repeating. So what is the period? The period, that means, or the block, is equal to 45. That means 4 and 5 is repeating. And what is the periodicity? Periodicity is, that means how many number of digits repeating? 4 and 5 repeating, means how many number of digits? 2. So the periodicity is 2. Okay, let us see, what about this number, 2 by 7. Okay, 0, 2, 14, 6, 56, 4, some 5, so 35, again 5, 7, 7, so 49. 1, 7 months are 7, 3, let us go like this, 30, 7 fives are, sorry, 7 fours are 28, 2. Okay, see, again reached the first dividend, 2. Right, when it is reached the first dividend, so it is certain that again the same number of times or the same digits will be repeating after this. That means here how many digits are repeating? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in this block, how many digits are there? 6 digits are there. So what is the periodicity? 6 is the periodicity. And what is the period or what is the block which is repeating? 2, 8, 5, 7, 1, 4. So we can write like this, 2 by 7 is equal to 0.285714. Here after the same number of same digit will be coming. You see, if you want you can check it. Again 20. How many? 7 twos are 14. Again what will come? 6. 60. Again 60 is here. Same, no? 2 after 8. Same only will be coming. So you can check it like that. So since these digits are repeating, we put a bar above that. So here how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the periodicity is 6 and the period is the same thing, this block. Means 2, 8, 5, 7, 1. Right. Okay. But you observe all these numbers 1 by 3. 5 by 11 and 2 by 7. In all these cases, we got the decimal expansion and we understood that this decimal expansion is non-terminating. That means there is no ending for the decimal part. It will be going on like that. And also, same digits are repeating. It's 2n. A particular block will be repeating. Maybe the block contains one digit like this. Maybe having two digits, three digits and so on. How many digits it may be? A particular block will be repeating. There is no ending for that. So, such numbers are called non-terminating decimals. Right? So, non-terminating and also recurring decimals. So, if any rational number is having non-terminating decimal expansion, whether its denominator follows this rule, 2 power n into 5 power n, already in rational numbers with the decimal expansion, which are terminating, we learned that q should be in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. Means denominator will be as 2 power n into 5 power n. So in this case, is the denominator is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m? Just to check it, here 3 is there. Can we write 3 as 2 power n into 5 power m? 3 itself is a prime number. Can we write 3 as the form of 2 power n into 5 power m? Not possible. See here 11. Can we write it? No. And 2 by 7? No. We can't write. So when we are examining more and more examples, we will identify that this non-terminating recurring decimals, if we are writing that one into rational numbers, its q should not be, its q will not be in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. So, this is a theorem. Let x is equal to p by q. X is p by q here. So, be a rational number such that, what is the speciality? The prime factorization of q, when the denominator is prime factorizing, is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. Okay, remaining part we know where n and m are non-negative integers, and then x has a decimal expansion and which is non-terminating and recurring, or otherwise repeating. So this is non-terminating recurring decimals in rational numbers. Okay, here is a question given. Without performing division, state whether the given rational numbers will have terminating or non-terminating repeating decimal form. Okay, already we learned if it is terminating, it will be, its denominator will be in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. If it is non-terminating recurring, its denominator will not be in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. So, we have to see the prime factorization of all the denominators. Then we can decide whether they are in terminating form or otherwise in the non-terminating form. There is no need of dividing and seeing. Okay, the first number 125. We know that 125 is equal to 5 cube, right? So 5 cube is in the form of 2 power 0 into 5 power 3. That means 2 power n into 5 power n. So it is in the form of 1. Denominator is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. So it is a 16 by 125 is a terminating decimal. Okay, that only our question. Without performing division, state whether the given rational numbers will have terminating or non-terminating. Okay, we have found out that it is having a terminating decimal. How did we get that it is having terminating decimal part? Because we found that it is in the form, its a denominator is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. Okay, let us check the next question. 100 by 81. Okay, 100 by 81. So, the question is 100 by 81. We know that 81 is equal to 3 power 4, right? 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, 3 power 4. So, whether 3 power 4 is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n? No. So, denominator denominator is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power n. So this is the way how to write. So 100 by 81 is non-terminating recurring decimal. Okay, understood. So this is the way how to write. We have to find out the prime factorization of denominator. After the prime factorization of the denominator, if the denominator we are getting in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, then we can say that that is a terminating decimal. And if it is not in that form, we can say that that is non-terminating recurring decimal. Okay, let us see the next question. 41 into 75. Okay, let us see the next question. 41 by 75. So we know that 75 is equal to 3 into 5 square. Okay, there is 5 power m part is there, but where is 2 power n? Here only 3. So is it in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m? No, it is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m. Denominator, you can write, it's not in the form of what? 2 power n into 5 power n. So it is a, so the number, so it is a non-terminating recurring decimal. Okay, so let us see the next question. 34th question, let us see. 13 by 3125. Okay, let us write 3125. Let us prime factorize it. 3125. 5 6 5 2 5 5. Again we can take 5. Right? 5 2 5 5 25. Again 5 2 7. 5, 6. Okay, here we got only 5s. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 5 power 5 is equal to 5 power 5. So, what did you understand here? It is in the form of 2 power n into 5 over m. So we can write so 13 by 3125 is a terminating decimal. Okay, whenever you are getting in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, we will write that it is terminating. Right? If we are not getting in the form of, the denominator is not in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, then we will write it is non-terminating recurring decimal. Okay, in your exercise also some questions are there that you have to do as well. Oh, 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 oh